Hi, it's Glenn back in the studio. Today we're moving on to the copper foil method. And copper foil method is using rolls of this copper, which if you look at what it is, it's got a very sticky back on it and a paper that peels off. And on small pieces, you can apply it by hand. Although when you get this very narrow profile copper, which leaves a nice finer edge here, you're going to want to use what's called a tabletop foiler. It has a few different size wheels, which are used for different size copper foils. So this particular one that's on here, basically how it works is there's an O-ring in here and the copper foil is snaked around here. I'll show you once I set it up. The glass is put over here and we run the glass through the I guess this is a jig of some kind. Through the circle, and you can change the height to adjust exactly where it goes. And once we do that, I'll show you what the next step is. But this tool here is fantastic for doing a lot of work, because once you put the glass through the foiler, it goes on nice and straight. So just one moment, I'll be back, I'll set this up, and then I'll show you how to foil up a piece of glass. Okay, so this is set up now. The foil is here in between these three little holders. The foil comes around on this pin here, comes up to the splitter where the backing goes one way, and the sticky side of the tape now goes inside the wheel here, and so you can see it coming out here. So in order to do a piece of foil, first thing you need to do is make sure that the glass is clean and that the edges have been ground. Okay, you can see that white there, and what that does is it provides a sticky surface, or a surface for the sticky side to actually adhere to. It's a little rough, and so it provides a little bit of tooth. So now what we want to do is say turn this around here like this so you can see it better, and you'll see that this particular size glass and this particular size wheel and this copper foil all basically match. If you have a thicker type of glass or a thinner type of glass, you might have to go to a different wheel. But so what we're going to do is basically we start off by pushing the glass at the corner into the wheel and rolling the glass around so that the copper foil adheres. We're just going to give it a try. We go along straight. Okay, now we're going to turn the corner. We're going to go this way. We're going to turn the corner again. We're going to go like this. Okay. We'll go down here like this. And what we're going to do is pull it off here and attach the last bit by hand. Okay, so we're going to cut this little end off here on this side. Then lay this down square onto the glass. Then we're going to come around a little bit and just give it a little pull, and off it comes. So now what we need to do is we need to get our chopstick. We need to finish the edges here. First of all, we go around the outside to make sure that the lead is properly stuck and the edges are stuck. We want to smooth it out. Then we want to come to the top, and we basically want to fold the copper down over into the glass. Okay, so we start in the middle here, and we just kind of take our chopstick, just kind of smooth it out. When you get to the end here, just go like this. Okay, and then you can just give it a little roll like that. Okay, come around to this side here. Pull it onto the glass so it sticks. Same with this side here. Okay, when you get to the edge, you have to sort of pull it in, roll it in like that. Okay. Go to the other side and do the same thing. Around, around, down like this. Okay. And what I like to do is put it on a flat surface and just kind of push it down to make sure it's all flattened. And now you've got a piece of glass that's foiled. And now once we have some more pieces, we can actually put them together, put the flux between there, and solder them together. Okay, so now for our project, we're going to be using this piece of curved glass. And it's the same principle with the curved glass. Basically, for the straights, we start with the corner to get it nicely fixed, run it down. Oh, see now it's... Okay, sometimes you have to... You know, this piece of glass is a little different. It's maybe it's a little bigger. Okay, so I'm going to have to maybe back this wing nut off of just a hair so that it raises the wheel. Okay, let's try it again. There we go. Okay, so we're going along here. Putting the piece on there. And here it gets a little tricky. I have to pull it back. And like this. Pull it off. Okay, and then straighten your end out like this. Okay, and then again, you need to just maybe go around a little bit first of all with your fingers to just press it in. Okay, to make sure it's on the right side. Okay. And then we want to take our chopstick, go around, make sure it's all stuck on there properly. Because if we don't stick it on there properly when we go to solder it, it won't stick properly to the solder, and the joint will fail. So there we go, around here. As you can see, this is a little thicker of a glass. But that's great, because this side that we want out with the texture has got a good amount of copper on it. And there we go. Okay. So there's the first piece for our project. And we'll just proceed like that to the next pieces. And I'll come back. When I come back, I'll have all these pieces foiled up. And I'll show you how to solder the pieces into your project. Okay, thanks for watching.